So in pre-send, I'm going to leave these same effects on. I've got some reverb, a little bit of screamer drive, and some delay going. And
Well, first let's talk about the pedal cracker. So the idea there was a lot of vocalists want to use guitar effects for their vocals, and so the pedal cracker is a preamp with phantom power, and it has an effects loop that's tailored for the level and impedance of guitar pedals. So it allows you to use the guitar pedal for your vocals or any microphone really, a saxophone, a horn, whatever. And it has a lot of features like a momentary on-off mode, which I think he showed you, and then a latched on-off mode. You can have trails on, you can have a pre-send, so you're always sending to the loop, and it only comes back when you want it. There's a lot of options, and we've had a lot of vocalists here this weekend playing with it,
right.
And they just see the creative possibilities that it brings them, which I'm not a vocalist, so I had the ideas in my head of what it could do, and then to see the vocalist here, like, they get this bright look in their eye and go, wow, all the things I could do with this, and that it's like validated that what I was going for was working.
When Daniel was doing the trails as well, and the momentary release, as well as doing the triads, he was able to harmonize with himself.
Right.
Which is fantastic. Did you have that in, was that even on your mind when you first put that together?
Yeah, one of the big things I was assuming is people are going to want to use a delay pedal on it. So that trails option was, you know, you could layer yourself over yourself, and, you know, one of the other vocalists was using it to accent parts. So he would sing a phrase with no effects, accent the last word with the effects, and then he would go back to dry, the trails would continue as he's singing the next phrase, and it just layered really nicely.
And of course, with a looper, it would really come alive, wouldn't it?
Right, oh yeah, you could do so many. I mean, it's just, possibilities seem endless. I mean, the more different vocalists come in here, the more ideas I'm seeing them come up with. So it's basically a creative tool.
This is a nice feature just on the tap delay here as well. We have if you're a guitarist and a singer, what you might have is two chains running parallel, and then you could be sharing a few things. I think for most vocalists, I feel like usually reverb delay is kind of the go-to, not using as much modulation, that kind of thing. And so I think we may start to see more vocalists starting to have pedal boards, which would mark the first time in history they ever load their own gear. So that'd be great.
Well, that's good.
Yeah, absolutely.